Hi, I'm Kelsey, a student at GD High School and a co-host of Senior Spotlight, a cable access TV program that highlights the activities at the Groton Senior Center where I volunteer. So, what is cable access? Well, we'll start with an abbreviated history of cable access in Groton, presented by three other GD students, Sam, Cam, and Alan. It started in 1981.
Hello.
Hello and welcome. I'm the town of Groton.
Hi, Groton. I'm United Cable, and I'd like to run my wires through your town so that I can expand my cable television business.
That's exciting, but what's in it for me?
Well, of course, we're going to give you a franchising fee, and your community can have its very own cable access channels. Your community is going to be on TV.
Cable access? What's that?
Let's take a look.
Oh, whew. Cable access is generally broken up into three different categories: public, educational, and government. Public access is an avenue for residents to express themselves creatively, politically, or informatively as protected by the First Amendment. Educational access can be anything related to the local schools or any other kind of education-based programming. Government access is a way for residents to follow the local governments by showing important public meetings.
That's great! You've got a deal.
Excellent.
Later in 2002...
You know, during this renewal period, we'd like it if you took over management of the Groton Cable Access Channel.
Well, that's fine. Oh, we'd like to jazz it up a bit anyway. You'll, of course, continue to fund it.
Of course.
Ah, that's better. And the money you give us will be adequate so that no taxpayer money is needed?
Of course.
And that will include equipment, personnel, and their benefits?
Everything you said.
And rent?
Yep. Well, we already have a brilliant plan worked out with the school district, but we'll have somebody talk about that later.
Now?
Yeah, let's do it now.
Now.
Hi, I'm Corey.
And I'm Zoe. We're both videography students at the high school.
And Groton Channel volunteers.
Groton Cable Access began its relationship with Groton Dunstable School District right from the beginning, when United Cable was looking for a space to set up an access studio in 1985.
The school district, knowing that this would present new opportunities for the students, generously provided an area in the basement of the old high school. A large storage space became the studio, and an adjoining room provided office and editing space.
Years later, when plans were being put together for a new high school, the school district and the Groton Cable Advisory Committee worked hard to design a facility that could house more and better equipment and provide greater accessibility to the public. The result is what exists today.
The Groton Channel is now located on the lower level of the new high school. It consists of a studio space with a lighting grid, a control room, two edit suites, an equipment room, and an office. It also has its own entryway so that the Groton Channel can operate even when the school is closed.
By virtue of being in the high school, the equipment and staff of the Groton Channel become easily accessible to the students. Here's Steve to talk about that.
Hi, I'm Steve. I'm a GD student and I also volunteer at the Groton Channel. The Groton Channel brings well over $100,000 of equipment to the fingertips of the GD students. This includes three professional studio cameras, a fully equipped control room featuring a digital switcher capable of hundreds of effects, two digital editing suites, a teleprompter, an extensive music library, a GlideCam stabilization system, seven field cameras, two take-home editing suites, sets, monitors, and much more. Additionally, the Groton Channel is staffed by knowledgeable and helpful employees who offer assistance and instruction. With the help of students and other volunteers since the fall of 2004, the Groton Channel has shown over 50 school concerts and events, more than 100 district meetings, and 150 sporting events, and the school's videography class has produced nearly 50 complete shows. And there's more.
Hi, I'm Heather, a former GDHS news anchor and producer of Groton Trails, a guide to our town's 10 best. The Groton Channel has also provided two camera kits with tripods to the GD Middle School and is currently providing equipment to the Prescott School, which is working on an oral history project. In addition to the many volunteer opportunities in and out of the school, the Groton Channel offers paid summer internships to high school students. These projects have ranged from zombie movies to historical documentaries and have cumulatively earned high school students over $13,000 in the past 3 years, all from the Cable Access Fund. Several GD students have also been hired as freelancers to record Groton Selectmen's meetings. The Groton Channel also offers free workshops in video production that would cost hundreds of dollars at a production school.
The opportunities continue to grow. The Crusader Sports Report is produced entirely by volunteer students, and there are three more student-produced shows in development. Recent successes for the Groton Channel and the school district include Fox 25 selecting GD News as a finalist in their high school journalism contest, Comcast Sportsnet selecting a GD student as a winner in their Fancaster contest, and the Robotics Club was the subject of a parent-produced documentary which won a first-place prize in a video festival that encompasses all of New England and New York. The synergy between the school district and the Groton Channel has produced wonderful opportunities and results, and it promises to be even better in the future.